Pendiona.
And then ask for time. But now, one of the things that you are supposed to do, the moment you have done that, is to go back to that court and tell them what you have done. Or you file a record of the things that you have done, so that in case you're asking for more time, you tell the court what you want to do. Unfortunately, this is where they fail miserably. So then 49G then goes away. So we come in under 49A. The accused person has been brought to court within a reasonable time, subject to argument. But they are here. So the next thing they're supposed to do now is to give you compelling reasons. If we have to go by any definition of compelling reasons, that has to include the thesaurus and the Oxford Dictionary, which just means one thing. It must be forceful, that reason. It must be compelling. Yeah. Most of all, it must be convincing. So this is what this affidavit is supposed to have. Well, these courts have seen so many authorities in relation to any allegations made by the prosecution. And let me just say, the reason why we have this fundamental right to prevent these excesses from the state. So they come and tell you the accused persons are going to interfere with the excesses. In Richard Alden versus Republic and in the case of Swagarai versus Republic, what did the court say? For the prosecution to come and say that they are going to interfere with witnesses, they must show how they come to that conclusion. Not guessing, not assuming. How you come to that conclusion. And that must be by facts. So which witnesses are they saying are going to be interfered with? Where and when do they intend to do this? How did they come to this information? Do they fall under the category of what we call the protected witnesses or vulnerable witnesses? Then we have the witness protection program. So as we stand here, is that a compelling reason? Our answer is simple. No. Another reason is investigations. Why are we in court? Why did we bring the accused persons to court today if we are not completing investigations? And which investigations are these that you need to have the accused persons present with you? Because if you are going to talk about telephones, they do not work with service providers. If you are going to talk about statements from other witnesses, they are not the police. They do not do that work. If you are going to talk about data from the computers and all these things, they do not do that. Which other reason then is there? You know, it's very simple, because for them to have come with these reasons and they are not compelling, then what happens? Then the right becomes absolute. Initially it is not, but they fail, it becomes absolute. And so if it has become absolute, then Article 19 must come in, because that says very clearly, these rights are fundamental rights that belong to an individual and not the state. So they cannot come here with an affidavit that is so plain, such a blanket cover, and expect you to believe. Not today, not ever. In the affidavit, they are saying that the court only granted one day. But we all know that the accused persons have been in custody since the day they were arrested. Not one day. And if it was one day that they were supposed to have done this investigation and presented, why did they come to this court? Why did they waste that day and come here in the morning, when that day could have been utilized, and go back to that court that they were supposed to go to? Doesn't that show you mischief? And if then you conclude that it is mischief, have they come to this court with clean hands? Then that will be the question. And if not with the clean hands, then they cannot come and ask for equity. You cannot grant them that today, not ever again. Article 20 and 21 are very simple, Your Honor. They encompass, I have searched high and low, and in this particular document, which again we will not even allow, is at best weak. The rest my colleagues have covered, it's a photocopy, but at least I'd want to confirm one thing. When somebody says in an affidavit sworn before me, that means that person is present in front of the person commissioning it. So when you bring a photocopy, where was it photocopied and made before it was brought to the commission? Again, is it true? Is it a fact? Is it genuine? I don't want to say that they are lying, but then again, what else can I say? They are lying.